Big construction firms are using project schedules to resolve challenges they are facing in today's world, like being able to complete the project on time and under budget, or being able to coordinate their complex project among the project team. But while we're using construction schedule as a tool to fix these problems, there are several myths and misconceptions about project scheduling, which I want to discuss in this video. Myth number one. We can have the most accurate schedule if we get the most expensive tools or the best scheduling software on the market. Well, just because we have money to spend on tools and softwares does not mean we can guarantee the best results. There is this term used by computer engineers called garbage in, garbage out. So if we don't spend enough time on planning the project scope or finding the correct data like activities duration, sequencing of activities, or planned resources, all we can expect to get out of any scheduling software is a beautiful looking but a very useless schedule. Quality of any schedule does not just depend on the technology we use, but also on the people involved in building it and the management of the schedule. Myth number two. If you're good at using a computer or learning a new software, you can be a good scheduler. I can tell this from my personal experience, where I worked with people who didn't have any construction-related experience but were able to get scheduler's position at a construction firm. The main problem was, even though they knew how to use a scheduling software, they had a hard time understanding the terms like earned value management or resource loading or any construction terminologies. It just makes job harder and unproductive. To be a good scheduler, it's more than just being able to use the softwares like Primavera or MSP. As a scheduler, you have to be good at communicating your schedule with the project team and the project manager. Myth number three. CPM schedules are useless and are only required because it's asked by client or the owner on the project. I have worked on multi-billion dollar transportation and infrastructure projects, where a contractor is usually required to submit a baseline schedule as per the contract. However, during this time when I was working as a scheduler for the owner, we received a horrible baseline schedule from the contractor, with several errors in it and poor work breakdown structure and sequencing of activities. It's important to understand that CPM schedules are legal documents and are binding in most contracts. So when a contractor is unable to perform as per their own baseline schedule and a delay claim is filed, and if it goes to an arbitrator or to a judge, contractor becomes liable to pay for all the delay related expenses caused on the project. And this all happened because contractor thought schedules were useless and not legally binding them. Myth number four. We don't need an expensive scheduling software. I have it all in my head. These are the words of a project manager I worked with previously. My project team had to convince her that having a schedule in a software or on paper is an efficient way of communicating with everyone involved on the project. Schedule in someone's mind is just not of any use to others.